How do I make sure malware is gone? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's kind of a composite question that I've gotten over the years. My computer had a virus, and one of those screen and attention-grabbing call this number scam things. I was able to remove it with my security software. Yay? How do I know it's completely, thoroughly, and permanently gone? The news here isn't great. Ultimately, you don't. I hate to say it, but there's a very important adage here that I think everyone really needs to understand. Once infected with malware, it's not your computer anymore. And that holds true even after you believe you've removed the malware. Now, that's not to say that there isn't hope of recovery, but it does really point out the seriousness of the situation. Now, I want to clarify what I mean by it not being your computer anymore. Remember that malicious software, once on your computer or other device, can do anything it wants to. Not all malware does, and indeed not all malware can, but the fact is that there's a lot out there that, if it can, it will and does take over your machine in ways you might not expect, and in ways that are difficult, if not impossible, to detect. You don't want to place bets on what kind of malware you happen to have, the kind that doesn't take over your machine, or the kind that does. They may look exactly the same as you use your machine. The second, however, could be laying in wait to do something nasty. It could be silently doing something nasty you might not notice, like collecting keystrokes, or it might cause unexpected behavior, like system slowdowns, as your machine turns into, say, part of a botnet. Once it's on your machine, malware can do whatever it wants, and that means it's become the malware's computer, not yours. Now, the single most common advice given when trying to remove malware is to scan. Specifically, update your security software, scan with your security software, scan again with your security software, and try an additional scan with some other security software. I've seen people repeat the last step until their machine is chock full of security packages that end up doing more harm than good. And even after that, there's still no guarantee that malware doesn't remain behind. To be clear, most malware will be caught, flagged, and removed. The tools will do their work, and generally, they work well. It's just that nothing is perfect. All of the tools miss things. And some malware tries very, very hard to be the malware that's missed. 99 times out of 100, running those scans is plenty. It's the 1% left that's of concern. Remember, the question here is how to make sure that the malware is gone. You want a guarantee. Guarantee number one, this one's fairly easy, but you have to prepare. You can remove the malware and know that you've removed it by restoring your machine to an image backup that was taken prior to the malware's arrival. Then, just avoid doing whatever it is that allowed the malware to start. This is one of the two most important things that image backups are really for. It's relatively easy, it's relatively fast, and it's guaranteed. It's also something you need to have been doing prior to needing it. This is another reason why I so strongly recommend and keep harping on daily image backups of some sort. A little preparation can go a long, long way. Guarantee number two, the nuclear option. If you've not been backing up regularly, as I've been suggesting, the only way to know that you've removed malware is to erase everything. Everything would, by definition, include the malware. Unfortunately, everything also includes the operating system, your data, your installed programs, everything. The process that you would go through looks like this. You would actually back up your existing hard drive so as not to lose anything important. You would then reinstall Windows from scratch, You would then reinstall applications from scratch, and you would restore your data from your backup or somewhere else. All that just to get rid of malware? No. All that to make certain you got rid of malware. To be clear, I'm not suggesting you drop everything at the first sign of malware and reinstall everything from scratch. I am, of course, suggesting that you begin backing up regularly, however. Sometimes that 99% certainty is plenty. Sometimes 99% is enough to at least carry on, unless there are other signs that you're part of the 1%, like whatever caused you to discover that you had malware in the first place, and that you need to take more drastic measures. But if you want or need an actual guarantee, you have two options: restore from a backup prior to the infection, or reinstall from scratch. That's it. Now, I do have to talk a little bit about BIOS/UEFI compromise, because whenever I talk about recovering from malware and how a full format and reinstall are the only real guarantee, I get pushback that they're not. If your BIOS or UEFI have been compromised, even the nuclear option won't help, since it doesn't touch them. To begin with, there's no such thing as perfect security. None. It's a spectrum. The goal here is to be as safe as you can possibly be. Second, just because something might be possible doesn't mean it's happening to you, or that it's even likely to happen to you. BIOS/UEFI compromises are very rare. There's plenty of more common malicious approaches that represent a much greater risk, and all of which are covered by the process I've just talked about. Put another way, I don't worry about BIOS/UEFI attacks specifically at all. I follow safe security practices overall, which keeps me safe from all malware, regardless of it being a keylogger or ransomware, a bot, or something else entirely, such as some kind of BIOS/UEFI compromise. I recommend you take the same approach. The best thing you can do overall, of course, is to never ever need to even ask this question. Practice safe internet habits. And regardless, start backing up now. Create image backups regularly. As you've seen above, that's the easiest way to get you the guarantee that you're looking for. And if you do find yourself in this situation, you should now have a much better understanding of exactly what to expect. For comments, for links related to this topic, and more, visit askleo.com/177076. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.